Right, Tamanna, so we did report a little while ago about in July, if I'm not wrong, where we said that these bidders had received the RBI's nod or the fit and proper approval. And now it looks like they are the only two bidders left in the race. Kotak Mahindra Bank, which was part of this entire crew, has seemed to have dropped out now. What sources are telling us is that Prem Vatsa, while he already owns CSB Bank through Fairfax Financial, is looking at a way where he could create a special structure where IDBI Bank can be held in that structure, and then the merger between IDBI Bank and CSB, which is one of the requirements that are there as part of the RBI's approval, that can happen a little later. So initially try to turn around IDBI Bank under this special structure and then eventually merge the two banks that he controls. Emirates NBD, of course, they will have to create an Indian subsidiary to ensure that the purchase happens through that entity and that IDBI Bank remains an Indian-owned bank, even though the owner of the Emirates NBD remains a foreign player. You know, these are important moves primarily because what we understand from sources, what Srimi Chaudhrya, my colleague, had reported a few weeks ago, where she said that the government is looking to close this entire process in the next few months. Hopefully by March, the government is expecting financial bids. In the coming few weeks, these bidders will be allowed entry into the data room where they can do due diligence into IDBI Bank and then formulate their bids for the bank. That entire process is being set in motion. That's why it's important to know who exactly is in the race, and it seems it's Prem Vatsa as well as Emirates NBD who are fighting it out for IDBI Bank.